by the end of I had a lot of fun with it too, but by the end of it, I was just so mentally drained and so exhausted that I would find myself saying in interviews, like, what do you want me to say? Because you're obviously not letting me out of this chair.
You'd ask the producer, yeah, and they're filming for the show, and you're saying, yeah, tell me what you want me to say.
Yeah, because at this point, like, you guys are going to take what you want anyways. So, like, what do you want from me? And I was just so gassed from everything. I just was done. And I ended up, so I had three guys left, the whole fantasy suites, and it was a very controversial season because I slept with one of the guys before the fantasy suite. And that was just a whole, like, the bachelor world hasn't seen that. And
ratings skyrocketed.
Yeah, exactly. And it was just so interesting because I'm like, I mean, there's fantasy suites. You go into a room overnight with three different men. That's not weird to bachelor world, you know? That's like, well, yeah, that's what happens on the show. But you did it before? That, you know, like, that was just so mind-blowing to everybody that it really blew up. And I ended up getting a lot of slack for that and a lot of hate online. And I just would cry in my bed every night. I lost so much hair from stress. I just was, like, devastated that people could genuinely hate me for just being who I was and what I would do in a relationship. And, I mean, I got told I should burn in a dumpster. And I don't know what kind of language I can use on your show, but you can bleep it out.
Oh, you
but
know,
like,
bleep us out.
Okay. like, shut my whore legs and how I'm disgusting and nobody would ever want their daughter to look up to me. And all these awful things just kept pouring in.
Heart-wrenching.
And I think Hannah is going through that right now as the Bachelorette because she did, like, a naked bungee jumping
right.
date. And people just really rip into you. And once, you know, it's hard enough to hear that from one person, but you're hearing it from, like,
thousands.
Hundreds of thousands.
Oh, my gosh.
And it was just really, really hard. And then I ended up picking somebody who, you know, because I had taken all the relationships as far as I could to really figure out who I liked, you still don't know the person you're getting engaged to at the end. So I went with who I felt the most confident with in my feelings, and we got engaged, and then, you know, we had a 3.5-year relationship out of it. But that was something that the show was always a topic in our relationship, and it was always just too hard for Sean to move past, and I was always made to feel a lot of shame around that. And so I did a lot of self-work and going to a therapist to not have that false guilt and that false shame about what I did, because I couldn't take it back. I wouldn't take it back. And I was just so confident in my decision by the end from, you know, with my relationships with the other people. I was like, no, I know I want to be with this one person. And so I think it's hard for anyone to come out of that show and have a successful relationship. And that's why it doesn't have the greatest success rate, because, I mean, I can understand why. And some people get through it and some people don't. But that's led me into where I am today. And I'm in a happier relationship for it. And everything, you know, the slut shaming or whatever you want to call it actually gave me a platform to have a voice for women. And it gave me the opportunity to say, like, hey, I love this feeling of empowering women. And I had so many women hate me, yes, but I had so many women come forward and say, thank you for being so real on this show. Thank you for doing what all of us women would do. And, like, good for you for not trying to be someone you're not, because that's not what we want to see on TV anymore. Everyone on The Bachelorette, you know, and I'm not saying that's not who they are, but a lot of them are the cookie cutter girl next door, all American sweetheart, and that's great, but that's not me, and I wasn't going to pretend to be that. And